Here's some free files that you need to check out for your Bamboo Lab A1. Probably one of the first things you actually need to print for this thing is going to be something to catch all the inevitable poop that's just going to be spewing everywhere. This little free file here, it's small, it's not too large, it's just the right size poop bucket. Kind of funny, right? So what's nice about this one is it just fits right here. It just sits into the curve nicely. It's got a little ramp to help keep the poop to go down. I printed this in some Sunlu marble PLA. I gotta say, it turned out really cool. It's one of the first things I printed with this marble filament, and I really like it. All right, so now we need something that's actually gonna help keep the poop in the bucket. With this little tiny deflector shield, this thing just attaches right here, and it gives the poop something to hit and to fall into the bucket. It's a super easy print. If you're gonna own a Bamboo Lab A1, you definitely wanna have the poop bucket plus this little deflector shield. When I first built this thing up, I messed up. I missed it in instructions or something, but I did not attach this cable to this little housing here. And subsequently, I came home to a print that had decided to fuse the hot end onto this cable. Now, these little prints right here are going to negate that from ever happening again, because I have actually had it come off this little AMS retention clip here before.
So these things are cool because they're flexy.
Everything kind of stays up and perky. Another cool option that you can do to kind of protect this cable is this guy right here. And this is just a simple retention clip that clips onto the top right here, and you can feed the cable through the back. And now you're definitely not gonna have this thing falling down into the path of the tool head. The cable is going to stay where it needs to stay, and it's not gonna get into any trouble, because the last thing you want is for this to hit the hot end like it did for me and start a fire. And thankfully mine didn't start a fire. But if you are wondering, this cable right here is literally just a USB-C cable. Thankfully with Bamboo Lab, I was able to just go online and order this part without a problem. They actually sent me one as a warranty replacement as well. So if you picked up the A1 combo and you got the AMS light here, just sits next to the side of the printer and it takes up a really big footprint, and I didn't like that. So Bamboo Lab actually has this on Maker World from them, and it is a vertical mount for your AMS light. This thing is really cool. It's fairly easy to print. They have a great instruction video that you can go in and watch. I printed this in PLA, but if you wanted to do something a little more exotic, like print it ABS, which is gonna be a lot more stronger and you wouldn't have to worry about all this extra weight up here, you could use the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. PCBWay is super cool because you can go online and upload your files and they will print these for you in even like peak or just crazy materials. Realistically, you could print this in ABS with them to last a long time. It's going to be strong, but they also do metal 3D printing, SLS. They do CNC machining, injection molding, PCBs. So if you're interested in checking out PCBWay, hit the link down in the description below. Now, if you want to hear more about my thoughts about this AMS light vertical mount here, let me know down in the comments below if you want to see a video just dedicated to that. I like it, but I think there's a couple things that kind of bug me about it. Up next is one of probably my favorite mods here, and this is going to involve this little extruder gear here. But it's kind of boring, wouldn't you say? Let's spice it up a little bit. All we got to do is from the bottom here, just pop this off. And then right here, we just pull this off. Bam. I've got my new one here, which is a Pokeball. This just slides right on to the shaft. And there we go. We just gotta put this back on. And now we have a little bit of customization in our Bamboo Lab A1. This actually works for the Bamboo Lab A1 Mini as well. There is another design that I'll put down in the description below. It's actually a flux capacitor one that I thought was super cool. I'll probably print that one next, so that way I can put it on my Bamboo Lab A1 Mini. If you ever wanted to remove the PTFE tubes from this right here, it is a royal pain if you don't have the right tool. I've tried to do this before with just like some needle nose pliers to push down and to pull in the tube, and it just didn't work. So this is super nice to have. This is literally just a little tab thing that allows us to push down on the release and pull up on the PTFE tube. Clamp around, push down and pull, and that's it. It's all it takes. And if you want to put it back in, you just slide it back in. Now without this, it's a royal pain to try to get these off. Even if you try to push these down, it just doesn't work right. That was like 5 or 6 really cool things to print for your Bamboo Lab A1. If I missed any that were cool, let me know down in the comments below so I can print them for this myself. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Consider subscribing to the channel if you want to see more content. If you want to see some behind the scenes content, consider joining my YouTube memberships down in the little join button right there. Now, before you go, you should probably check out this video right here because you know what? YouTube will probably think you like it.